Mara, thanks for that text. That was so sweet.
I wasn't able to see who was on and who's not, so I was like, I just want to make sure to let you know.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks.
Wow.
They were like, wow, yeah, can you hear that sometimes? Yeah, I do. It comes out sometimes. page insert where it says initiation of Crestor should be should start at 5 milligrams daily, and for specifically for Asian patients, just because of the sensitivity and how well you can lower it. And then after, this is specifically from the ACC guidelines too as well. Interestingly enough, when you look at the maximum dose of statins within Japan and United States, it's completely different, right? So we usually come and see the maximum dose of Lipitor at 80 milligrams. In Japan, it's 40. In like Crestor, it's like here it's 40, and then over there it's like 20. And this is all due to like data that they have that shows, you know, myopathy rates and you know, liver damage and whatnot too. So how can I translate this to everyday practice? So besides being aware of the clinical implications of statin use amongst different ethnicities, I think, you know, Dr. Sarvedi is going to be happy that I talk about this. But, you know, we're living in this very exciting time of medicine where, you know, with the advent of molecular medicine and advanced in next-gen sequencing, we're on the verge of being able to practice tailored medicine through pharmacogenetics. So luckily enough, the veterans, the VA, actually has a phaser clinical program, and they actually do these kind of testings. And specifically in this, in the phaser program, you don't have to, it's not like a clinical trial. You can order it, they can do it right, and then they just do it off of the blood test, and then they give you a report, and they can come back to that. So, wow, they actually have the SLOCO1B1 gene there that they're looking for. So you can actually translate to clinical practice here by being able to order this and being able to differentially see whether or not a patient is at risk for, you know, statin myopathy, if they're at risk for, you know, if they're sensitive, that you can maybe titrate the dose a little bit lower so that you can try to prevent further outcomes from them, like liver damage or anything else. So I think it's Dr. Sarfati would be very happy to announce it, because I remember her during clinic all the time promoting this and telling me, we should do this, we should do this. And I was like, oh, finally. So this is a great implication for this. So I think in summary, in regards to this, the ethnic differences in statin metabolism is an important consideration. Current guidelines and FDA recommendations mirror these findings, and they recommend ethnic consideration in regards to statin therapy. Polymorphisms can cause differential responses, and it's to the point where it's not just ethnic population for Asians, it's for everybody that we should be making these considerations. So we should all try to, for most people that are practicing in the VA, we should consider using the phaser trial or the, you know, this phaser program. And an effort is important to understand and undertake that in clinical trials, the ethnic makeup of study populations and polymorphisms can lead to differential outcomes for your patients. So I wanted to thank everybody, everybody here and whoever's not pictured, you know, like, thank you everybody for being a great mentor to me. I know that I still have almost a year to go, but you know, this is the time that I can say this. So thank you everybody for being a great mentor to me. And then, you know, thank you to my co-fellows. And then, you know, I put Jack and Nesbin's name down there because we don't have a picture with them. And then in the middle, that's my mentor from Hawaii. That she's a practicing endocrinologist at the VA. So, and then, of course, my wife, my father-in-law, and then my late father, but my mother as well, too, for supporting me to be who I am today. And then my 3 pages of references, and then any questions.
So we'll open up to questions. You can unmute or chat, put it in the chat box, and I'll monitor that. But let me just start, Eric. So one thing in the guidelines they always talk about, the 50% reduction or whichever percent reduction, the thing that I struggle with is a lot of the patients show up to us on a statin. And the question always is, well, what was their reduction? And it's not always possible to be able to find what the pre-statin LDL level was. I mean, do you have any words of wisdom there?
So actually, the guidelines mentioned that. So they said a lot of the times we're not able to know that. So then they said to actually do it off of that number, which is like less than 55 or less than 70. So that's what they're mentioning. So that's a very common question that it was mentioning guidelines. Yeah.
other questions here or online?
Sorry.
Yes. It's so clear, nobody has any questions.
Yeah. Clear as mud, right? Yeah.
Nice talk.
Okay, thank you.
Well, if we don't have any other questions, we'll let Eric go.